The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
This is the Wake Up Crew on News Radio WGNS. With John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
Good morning. Thank you. Thank you very much. Welcome to the Wake Up Crew. It's the 26th of July, episode 1457. And the first half day for schools is August 7th. That's 12 days away. Gosh, it's hard to believe. And tax-free weekend starts tomorrow. Because you know why it starts tomorrow?
It's today, isn't it? Yeah. Today through Sunday.
Oh, I'm sorry. Today? Sorry. Yeah. Well, you know what? Why it's today?
Well, I think I do.
It's Friday.
It's finally Friday. I got my motor running for a wild weekend. It's finally Friday. Forget the working blues and let your good times roll.
Yabba-dabba-doo. I was not counting Friday as part of the weekend because I'm in golf land when you go to play golf.
Oh, yeah.
Friday is a regular. You pay same amount as you do on the weekend, so I kind of got in funk there.
School supplies, clothes, computers, that kind of thing. Now, there is a limit on some of that.
You can't buy six computers.
Well, yeah, or school supplies if they're priced at $100 or less. Computers are tax-free if they're priced at $1,500 or less.
Okay, say that again. Like school supplies, if you don't spend $100, you don't get the...
No, each item has to be under $100.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Clothes, school supplies, that kind of thing. So under $100.
So is a backpack not considered a school supply, maybe?
I would think
so.
Well,
they'd be under $100 if you get a normal.
Right.
Not like my granddaughter's who get the most expensive backpack in the history of mankind.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's good to know. A lot of people do take advantage of that, though. It's a good time to buy a computer if you
need
one.
Yeah. Yeah. Qualifying items may be purchased online and in stores.
Ooh. Now, that's talking. And then they have, okay, do they ever have tax-free on the digital end, you know, like on a Monday or something? You know how they do Black Friday and... No, okay.
Yeah, but I mean, I think if you ordered these things online...
So you get them there, too.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just look for that, I guess.
Well, that'd be perfect for you.
Well, yeah, if I was going to...
Because you never go shopping.
Try not to. I can't remember if I've ever ordered anything on Amazon clothes-wise during that time or not. I may have to try that today just to see if it doesn't charge me tax. There's probably a way that they can do that and know that you're from Tennessee and
don't
charge you tax because they do collect sales tax now on all those online purchases.
Well, we're approaching the end of August. Of course, school's starting, baseball starting to, you know, the old trade deadline.
Yeah,
it's getting close to the end. Braves have had such terrible luck with injuries.
Injury prone.
Yeah, it's just been, and they're not hitting. I saw where an article in somewhere said Matt Olson needs to start hitting.
Well,
he's had a terrible year. Austin Riley hadn't had a great year.
Not really.
And Ozzie Albies, before he got hurt, was not having a great year.
They've had streaks.
It's funny how every one of them had a great year last year, and none of them are having a good year this year. And, of course, Acuna gets hurt. So,
is it that sophomore slump?
I don't know. If you're Alex Anthopoulos, what do you do at the trade deadline? I mean, it's like, wow.
They've still got a shot at the wild card, right?
Yeah, yeah. But they're not scoring any runs.
Yeah.
Their pitching's kept them in it. But now one of them pitching is kind of out for a while. So we'll see
how
that works.
Freed, right?
Max Freed, yeah. So same time last year he got hurt. And came back, but he just wasn't very good in the playoffs.
I'm sure we're going to have to hear. I know that they had a bad series last weekend with St. Louis.
Yeah, well, you know, Acuna – really means a lot to him because he's gets on base. I think instead of trying to find another power hitter, they need to find one of these little pesky guys that gets on base all the time. You know? Yeah. I think it helps.
They do like the power hitter, though, don't they?
Yeah, but I will say Marcel's had a good year. Ozuna, he's had a good year. So, but we're getting to that time where we're going down the stretch and you know, September, then the World Series, of course.
You got to decide whether you're going to put money in the program and make a run for it.
Right.
or right. if you're going to say, you know, this just isn't our year and kind of unload.
And the wild card has created a problem because you can be a few games under 500, but you might only be like three games out of the wild card.
Yeah.
So fewer teams are saying are cashing it in, and, you know, so makes it that much more difficult. Great Friday coming up with shows, and we're going to be What Are We Watching as well coming up in the second hour. Much more to come here on the Wake Up Crew. This is John. I'm John. You're Brian.
Yeah.
And we got it. 617.
Checking your Rutherford County weather. Patchy fog possible in spots early today. Otherwise, plenty of cloudiness, showers, and storms in the area. Highs top out near 87 degrees. Winds south around 5 miles per hour. And then tonight, any showers and storms end early. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. Patchy fog could redevelop in spots well after midnight, with lows dropping to 70. I'm weatherology meteorologist Phil Jenska with your Wake Up Crew forecast. Right now it's 73.
WGNS is powered by Middle Tennessee Electric, who offers energy saving tips during the hot summer months. Schedule heat-related chores like cooking, cleaning, and laundry to early morning or evening hours. For more tips, go to mte.com/myenergyplan.
Ascension St. Thomas Heart is the leader in Middle Tennessee for heart care, providing the most advanced options, including heart surgery and transplants. Our nationally recognized cardiac team cares for more adult hearts than anyone in the state, from AFib to heart failure, using minimally invasive options when possible to help shorten recovery, making Ascension St. Thomas Heart your first choice for routine heart care and cardiac emergencies. Schedule a heart screening or find a cardiologist at ascension.org/St. Thomas Heart.
LaGreen's Masonry is a local family business. They build quality brick mailboxes. LaGreen's Masonry has over 19 years' experience, and they're A-plus rated by the BBB. Check their website, lagreensmasonry.com.
Make one of our Rutherford County locations your pre- or post-voting spot. Stop by Toots and make sure you get out and vote.
Toots.
This is Nick Hayes with Toots Restaurants, reminding you to get out and vote and stop by one of our locations for a $6.99 lunch special afterwards.
Hi, this is Wade Hayes of Toots Restaurants. It's an election year, so it's very important that you get out and vote. Right, Jack?
Yep. It's real important that everyone gets out and vote this year.
Good food and fun.
Hi, this is Stan with Parks Auction Company, and by now you've probably heard our commercials and know that we are committed to helping you increase your investments. Call 896-4600 to set an appointment with me or one of my team members. That's 896-4600. Parks Auction Company, we handle everything.
This is Stan Vaught. I'm a lot like you, a husband, father, farmer, auctioneer, and community supporter. I'm now a candidate for school board. In the last cases, Walter Hill, Milton, Leanna, Oakland, and Siegel communities. I believe in community schools, vocational education, and getting education back to the basics. I'd appreciate your support for school board.
Early voting going on now through July 27th. Election day is August 1st. Paid for by Stan Vaught for school board, Stan Vaught treasurer.
Murfreesboro Funeral Home and Cremation Services.
She wrote this letter and gave it to my dad to have the minister to read at the funeral. It was very healing for the kids, even for the grandkids.
Let the Murfreesboro Funeral Home help your family when experiencing loss of a loved one.
From the Fox Sports Studios in Los Angeles, here's Eddie Garcia.
In Major League Baseball games of note, the Padres shut out the Nationals 3-0 in D.C. with San Diego starter Dylan Cease tossing the second no-hitter in franchise history. Nine innings, no runs, no hits, nine strikeouts, three walks through 114 pitches in the victory. And San Diego moves a half game in front of idle St. Louis for the final wildcard spot in the National League. Dodgers defeat the Giants 6-4. Clayton Kershaw in his season debut, coming back from shoulder surgery, had 72 pitches. Went four innings, two runs, five hits, six strikeouts, two walks, and a no decision. Shohei Ohtani hit his 31st homer of the year as the NL West leaders took 3-4 in the series against San Francisco. Guardians, the AL Central leaders, were shut out by the Tigers 3-0. Orioles on top in the AL East blew a 6-0 lead, but then beat the Marlins 7-6 in 10 innings for a two-game lead on the Yankees atop the division. Mets edged the Braves 3-2 and 10. Mets are now a half game back of Atlanta for the top wildcard spot in the National League.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
It's Friday, who cares? You know, I mean, who cares what we're doing today? We're in such a good mood.
You just mailing it in today?
That's what I'm going to do. Just mail it in. Just like a bird, just mail it in. You know, we're running out of weekends now, you and I.
I haven't brought it up at all.
Yeah, but I'm going to bring it up to make you feel bad.
I don't feel bad.
because you got to go get the food, you know. Now you're going to have to go get all the little sheets for us when we do our interviews. All those little pesky little things.
Maybe this will be a new year. Maybe you have to get your own pages.
No, I'm not doing that. The show's much better when you do it.
That's a lot of pressure.
Just showing up. But you like, you get into that. You like that. It's pressure of deadlines and that kind of thing. Hmm. Is that Brewer guy still going to work with us?
I think so. Yeah.
What about Blair? Is he going to be here?
I hope so.
Okay.
A little bit here and there.
We're going to have a Thursday show?
I think so.
Okay. All that's debuting pretty soon.
Well, it won't be long. I haven't done anything.
Less than a month.
Oh, yeah.
Away. Yeah, you haven't done anything. I know.
Not much.
Yeah. Well, you better start working on that schedule.
I've given you the schedule. I'm waiting on you.
Okay. Oh, you. Well, why do you wait on me to call people and to tell them I'm not going to be there? Hey, I need a guy that does color analyst. No, I may do more football than you'll be surprised.
Well, I thought you had your highlighter and everything yesterday.
My daughter had a good idea. My daughter made a good point about that, though. She said, "You know, Dad, it's only one game a week. It's when it goes to." Two games a week is when it gets really rough.
Yeah,
basketball. All right, enough about me. It's Song of the Day.
This is the biggest
one.
Hit of 1985.
Wow, didn't we have them on Wednesday or Thursday or Tuesday or something?
Yeah, wham.
Wham. That was a good song.
Yeah, it was.
That's deserving of number one.
A little slow song is number one, you know?
You know who's number one? In our hearts?
Brooke Walker.
That's right. Today's Good Neighbor of the Day for being there in an eye emergency. Brooke's going to receive flowers from the family over at Ryan Flowers Coffee and Gifts. Don't you think you'd like them to go in a little more detail when they do the Good Neighbor?
Well, I'm having an eye emergency right now. I can't see.
Oh, well. I won't be a good neighbor. Not qualified.
So if you want to send in a Good Neighbor of the Day nomination, you can do that. And all you have to do is text the word neighbor to 615-893-1450. You'll receive a reply from us. And then you'll just fill out the information on that web form, click submit, and that's all you have to do. Just a sentence. Now, I've gotten, and this may be one of those, I try to condense it down. So sometimes it's like a paragraph, and we don't have that long to explain. So.
Well,
that's probably my fault.
I do need to explain one thing.
What's that?
We're powered by Middle Tennessee Electric. That's right. They offer energy-saving tips during the hot summer months. Install programmable thermostats. Also, they'll tell you to set your temperature to 76 degrees in the summer. Yeah. And much more. So there you go.
All right. At birth, a Dalmatian is always pure white, no spots.
Oh, really? And then over time?
Yep.
Amazing. You're smart.
Here's a question. What do you want from your electric co-op?
Fast response if the power goes out.
An app that keeps me informed. Tips to lower my monthly bill.
Communication on things that matter to me.
Done, 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 done.
I want to know everything.
Everything? Well, young lady, let me show you the MyMTE app. Energy Service Life. That's Middle Tennessee Electric. We're here to get done what matters most to you. Learn more at mte.com.
Stones River Manor, the only faith-based nonprofit home for seniors in Rutherford County.
Everyone is so friendly. They really want to make you happy here.
Stones River Manor offers independent living.
When you get to our age and you live in a house, there's always things that's got to be done. Living here, I don't have to worry about anything.
You don't have a yard to mow. You don't have a roof to repair.
Just what you want to do outside.
Start the journey. They're near the intersection of Haynes Drive and Memorial Boulevard. Online at stonesrivermanor.com.
Now, an update from the WGNSradio.com News Center.
I'm Ron Jordan. Early voting in Tennessee is officially underway, but turnout is not as strong as it was back in 2020. As of Wednesday, 242,357 votes were cast early. That is 186,874 fewer than compared to the same time in 2020, an early 44% decrease. As of Tuesday, early voting turnout was almost 20% lower compared to 2020. The Coffee County Sheriff's Office has arrested a man in connection with the killing of a man at a home in Beech Grove on Wednesday. 37-year-old Thomas Anthony was a passenger in a vehicle in Manchester when he allegedly had a confrontation that led to shots being fired into a truck he was in. 40-year-old Philip Lee Meadows was identified as the shooter. He is in jail facing first-degree murder charges. A 22-year-old faces multiple criminal charges, including vehicular homicide by intoxication, in connection with a fatal car crash that killed her boyfriend the day after Christmas. The Tennessee Highway Patrol says Shakira Serenity Madrigal was driving north on I-65 when she lost control of her boyfriend Cade Warren's vehicle and hit a guardrail. The report states that the impact caused the guardrail to penetrate the passenger side door, killing Warren. The couple was reportedly traveling back to Michigan from Alabama after visiting Warren's mother when the accident happened. In June, a Williamson County grand jury indicted Madrigal on 4 charges of vehicular homicide by intoxication, 2 counts of ruckus endangerment with a deadly weapon, and driving under the influence. She was initially arrested in Michigan and later extradited to Tennessee. I'm Ron Jordan reporting.
The Good Neighbor Network, on air and online at WGNSradio.com. Rutherford County's most trusted source for local news.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
And good morning to you. Welcome back to the Wake Up Crew. It's 27 minutes after the hour of 6 o'clock. Got a lot coming up. Good Neighbor events. We've got Man on the Street. Newsmakers coming up, and weather, traffic, all those kind of good things we have every morning. We're glad you're aboard with us, and don't forget, in about 12 days from now, you'll be back on the road again taking those kids to school. I got one fixing to coming April, she'll be driving.
Wow.
One less. So.
And she can drive sister to school.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Wow. And Mama, they'll all be going in the same direction. So I don't know how that's going to work, but I would say little sister will go with Mama for a while.
Yeah,
you know, for at least till the end of the year, and Sis will drive her own.
Then you got to have, you know, gas money.
Yeah, well, the oldest one's pretty good about working. She doesn't mind working. She's babysitter.
Oh wow,
she'll watch dogs too. If you want to pay. I doubt that'll happen at your house. Lights, camera, and action, Brian. That's right.
Okay.
The nominations for the 76th Annual Emmy Awards are in. Want to
wow.
hear some winners?
Sure.
Or nominees. Sorry. It's a little different because I don't keep up with it like you do. Returning series, The Crown, The Beat Morning Show, and Hacks were among the series with nominations. Morning Show, you know
I've
that
seen
show.
The Morning Show and The Crown.
Jeremy Allen White, Gene Smart, Reese Witherspoon, and Dominique West. Dominique West is back in that. He's been in a lot of good shows.
What was the Jeremy Allen whatever?
Jeremy Allen White.
Yeah. That's probably for The Bear on Hulu. Yeah, I think. It's been really popular.
Other nominees are Shogun and Baby Reindeer. The new limited series Ripley also earned nods for Dakota Fanning and Andrew Scott. They tapped previous winners Cheryl Lee Ralph and Tony Hale, who earned for Abbott Elementary and Veep, to share the slate of nominees during a live stream ceremony. They were the presenters.
I see.
And this year's nominations had some familiar people honored the final seasons of shows such as Succession. Did you ever see that?
I did. Great
yeah.
show. Actually,
that's on HBO, wasn't it?
Yeah. Beth Priest told me that I should watch that, and I did.
Better Call Saul. Was
oh, yeah.
another one that's going to be in the categories. The Bear is nominated.
Mm-hmm.
All the shocking snubs and surprises were, well, let's see. The White Lotus was not up for any awards.
I haven't seen that. I keep hearing people. That's another HBO thing, I think, too.
I believe you're right. And let's see. Outstanding Talk Series. You want to know about those?
Sure. Why not?
Okay. The Daily Show. Jimmy Kimmel Live. Late Night with Seth Meyers. Late Show with Stephen Colbert. That's almost everybody.
Except for Jimmy Fallon.
Yeah.
Tonight Show.
Yeah, that's not doesn't bode well.
Snub.
Outstanding Reality Competition Series, The Amazing Race, Top Chef, RuPaul's Drag Race, The Traitors, and The Voice. Outstanding Lead Actor, Matt Bomer for Fellow Travelers. Richard Gadd, John Hamm for Fargo.
Fargo this last season was great.
Tom Hollander. And Andrew Scott for Ripley. And that's a few. We'll go over some more of them. We'll do the lead actress when we come back here in a few minutes.
Well, it is kind of like what we're watching today.
But we have to do Dad Joke, should be an award nominee itself.
It's won multiple awards.
In just a few minutes.
It's amazing.
But first, right now, you know what we got to do now.
I do.
It's time for
Today in history.
When you turn to Turner Security, powered by TechCore, you can leave your security issues at the door. Turn to Turner Security.
You're a good neighbor station, WGNS.
Ask not what your country can do for you.
I'm Ryan Beard.
Ask what you can do for your country.
I'm John Dinkins.
I have a dream.
This is Dalton Merritt.
Tear down this wall.
In 1896, Vitascope Hall, the first permanent for-profit movie theater, opens in New Orleans. Must have been hard to see on that little bitty screen. No, I'm just kidding.
It was probably a pretty quiet movie.
Yeah, it was quiet. 1917, J. Edgar Hoover gets a job in the U.S. Department of Justice, later become the head of the FBI. 1947, President Truman signs the National Security Act, establishing the Department of Defense, the CIA, National Security Council, and Joint Chief of Staff.
Well, now that's all under Homeland Security.
Mm-hmm. In 2018, Sir Paul McCartney performs a secret gig. Mm-hmm, a secret gig at the Cavern Club in Liverpool where the Beatles began.
Shh, don't tell anybody.
Don't tell anybody. The body of civil rights activist John Lewis crosses the Edmund Pettus Bridge in Selma for the last time. He was beaten up there 55 years ago with a military honor guard as part of a remembrance service. And that's a look at today in history. That's pretty good day.
Yeah, not bad.
Didn't have to do much on that one, did you?
No, just play a little Paul McCartney.
Kind of took it a little easy, I think, really, to be honest.
Well,
Brandon Brooks is standing by. He's got CBS Rewind, and we've got much more to come here on the Wake Up Crew. Don't go anywhere. Stay here with Brian and John.
This is CBS Rewind on July 26th, 1975. The Eagles hit the top of the album chart with One of These Nights. July 26, 1985.
Will you please slow down there?
The release of the Vacation sequel.
Hey, it closes in 15 minutes or 100,000 works of art to see. Come on.
National Lampoon's European Vacation.
Hey, look, kids.
Starring Chevy Chase.
There's Big Ben and there's Parliament.
And July 26, 1991.
Let's go to work.
The release of the Mel Brooks comedy,
hey, hey.
Life Stinks.
Critics
said the movie stinks.
I'm going as fast as I can.
I'm Brendan Brooks.
I'm Richard.
And that's Rewind.
Brought to you by Progressive Insurance. Progressive makes bundling easy and affordable. Get a multi-policy discount by combining your car, home, motorcycle, commercial, auto, and more. All your protection in one place. Bundle and save at progressive.com.
Checking your Rutherford County weather. Patchy fog possible in spots early today. Otherwise, plenty of cloudiness, showers, and storms in the area. Highs top out near 87 degrees. Wind south around 5 miles per hour. And then tonight, any showers and storms end early. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. Patchy fog could redevelop in spots well after midnight, with lows dropping to 70. I'm weatherology meteorologist Phil Jenska with your Wake Up Crew forecast. Right now it's 73.
Good morning. Cleanup continues on this crash over in Donaldson on Donaldson Pike right there at I-40. It looked like two cars may have hit head-on. They're trying to clean that up right now. A lot of folks are trying to get in that area to get to the airport on Donaldson Pike right there at the interstate. That crash south of Nashville is being wrapped up on 65 southbound there at Armory. See some rain moving towards the Middle Tennessee area. Give yourself extra time. Hey, Prince's Hot Chicken is hiring at all their locations. Log on to princeshotchicken.com. I'm Commander Chuck with your on-time traffic.
This is Good Neighbor Events with Bart Walker. Brought to you by the law offices of John Day and Americare Pest Control.
Here's Tom Sweat with Americare Services Incorporated.
Americare's moisture control services include mold testing, mold remediation, crawl space repair, vapor barrier, sump pump installation, radon testing, radon mitigation, and basement waterproofing. If there's something wrong in your crawl space or basement, we can probably help. Just ask for a free inspection.
893-7111. Americare Services Incorporated.
WGNS encourages you to shop local. The Woman's Club 2024 Legacy Gathering will be Saturday, August the 10th. It's not at the Woman's Club this year because they're totally renovating that 1858 home. But this year, the Woman's Club Legacy Gathering will be at Oakland's Mansion. That's 5 until 8 o'clock in the evening on Saturday, August 10th. Get with the Woman's Club. Visit their website, womensclubmurfreesboro.org. Now don't forget, this is the final week to take advantage of early voting. Would you like to learn more about Rutherford County? Well, you need to be over at the one-room Ransom Schoolhouse this coming Saturday morning from 9 until noon. Members of the Rutherford County Historical Society will be there to share local history. It's all free, including the coffee and donuts. That's this Saturday from 9 until noon. And Ransom School is at 717 North Academy Street. That's right here in the borough. Now please give the gift of life. Give blood at the Red Cross. Call them and make an appointment. That's 800-RED-CROSS. Those are WGNS Good Neighbor events.
You know, everyone has a more. First it's a pony, then to be on the cheer squad. Your more grows up just like you do, but your more can still carry you away or make you cheer. At First Bank, banking local gets you more. More of our time, more access to local bankers, more flexibility, and more product choices. Because getting more empowered and confident helps you pursue your more that never grows old. First Bank. Bank local. Get more. Member FDIC.
At Middle Point, we want to be part of the solution. That's why we're making significant investments in proactively enhancing our facilities to integrate sustainable solutions.
Mike Klassen with Middle Point Landfill.
We invite you to learn more about us at middlepointlandfill.com.
Middle Point Landfill is an environmentally safe, economical, and reliable solution for solid waste for Rutherford County.
For public services, we are sustainability in action.
Bob Ferris enjoys life at Adams Place.
I do physical therapy here and ride the bicycle. This morning I rode the bicycle for 20 minutes. At Adams Place, I enjoy the friendship. We have a good time.
Hi, this is Terry Deal at Adams Place. Call me for more information about Adams Place. Phone 615-904-9111. Adams Place, 1927 Memorial Boulevard, across from Walmart.
Here's Dr. Craig McCabe at McCabe Vision Center.
We have a full line of laser procedures.
Dr. Craig McCabe.
As well, we offer the Doctor brand of skin peels, as well as a full line of cosmetic pharmaceuticals. Make yourself look 10 years younger. Call McCabe Vision Center.
On Heritage Park Drive, behind SunTrust Bank.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
This is The Wake Up Crew with John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
It's time for the dad joke of the day. Nice guy.
It's 6:39. Welcome back to The Wake Up Crew. And Brian, we've had our much-needed rain this week.
Yes.
And not everybody's gotten as much rain. But
that's true.
You know, we've gotten several inches, so it's been good.
Well, you're always thankful to get July rains.
Thankful, but of course, we got to mow the yard again. That's part of the problem.
Welcome back to heat next week.
Again?
Yep.
There you go with that positivity.
Well, it is summertime.
Yeah, maybe no hundreds.
Let's hope not.
Mid-90s. We can live with that, I guess. Yeah. How about here's something that's piping hot right now. I mean, it's sizzling. The dad joke of the day.
Sizzling, is it? You know, the fact that Keith Richards outlived Richard Simmons makes me really question the whole eating healthy and exercising thing.
Say that again. That was good.
The fact that Keith Richards outlived Richard Simmons.
Yeah.
Really makes
I forgot who you said in the joke. I'm going 5 with that.
Are you now?
Yeah.
It was a little different.
I like that. It was almost like a story. You told a story.
Yeah.
Kind of offbeat. I liked it.
And with current news.
Yeah. You're right. 6:41 here on The Crew.
CBS News Brief. Chaos ahead of today's opening ceremonies at the Summer Olympics after French officials say arsonists hit railroad tracks into Paris. CBS's Elaine Cobb.
Paris police have opened an investigation for criminal damage to property aimed at damaging national interests. That after several high-speed rail lines were sabotaged across northern France. The French rail company says 800,000 travelers have seen their trains cancelled or delayed.
Flights have resumed at Mulhouse Airport after a bomb scare. It was the phone call Vice President Harris has been waiting for.
Kamala.
Hello. Hi.
Hey there.
This morning, former President Obama and former First Lady Michelle Obama endorsed Harris' bid for the presidency. Families of hostages in Gaza speak out after meetings in Washington with the vice president and Israel's Benjamin Netanyahu.
The moment they come home, these 115, the killing ends, the madness ends.
CBS News Brief. I'm Deborah Rodriguez.
Now, an update from the WGNSRadio.com News Center.
I'm Ron Jordan. Old Fort Golf Course will be reopened for golf on Friday, August 30th, following renovations. Golfers can begin scheduling tee times for the reopening 5 days in advance, beginning at 7 a.m., August 25th. The golf department started the $1.6 million renovation of Old Fort Golf Course in January. It started with bunker renovation, reshaping bunkers, adding new bunkers, and removing others. By mid-March, Old Fort started the green renovation by removing cool-weather bent grass and installing warm-weather prism zoysia. At that time, the golf department closed the entire course to golfers so work could proceed. More information on the Murfreesboro Golf Department, follow the link on WGNSRadio.com. The Golf Department also has a Facebook and an X page. The Coffee County Sheriff's Office has arrested a man in connection with the killing of a man at a home in the Beech Grove area on Wednesday. 37-year-old Thomas Anthony was a passenger in a vehicle in Manchester when he allegedly had a confrontation that led to shots being fired into the truck he was in. 40-year-old Philip Lee Meadows was identified as the shooter. He is now in jail facing first-degree murder charges. The Tennessee Department of Commerce and Insurance and the Tennessee Peace Officers Standards Training Commission announced a disbursement of grant funds to all eligible law enforcement officers and school resource officers. Each eligible law enforcement officer will receive an $800 retention bonus payment if they have completed their 2023 in-service hours and are still employed in law enforcement. $800 will also be awarded to all SROs who have completed the 2023-24 SRO academic year, as well as all applicable training. More details on our website, WGNSRadio.com. I'm Ron Jordan reporting.
The Good Neighbor Network, on air and online at WGNSRadio.com. Rutherford County's most trusted source for local news.
At Heritage South Community Credit Union, we help when others won't. It's what our members tell us we do every day. The older model car you need to get to work? Yeah, we've helped with that. When you have a financial emergency and don't know where to turn? We've helped with that. Repairing your credit? Yes, we've helped with that. How about a second chance at a checking account? We've even helped with that. Experience the Heritage South difference. Learn more at heritagesouth.org. Insured by NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Novatech, Middle Tennessee's local office technology and document solutions expert. Visit novatech.net. That's novatech.net. Novatech reflects the additional managed IT and print services now available to area businesses. Novatech's IT and print services provide businesses with a free cost analysis so you may easily choose the exact solutions to meet your needs within your budget. Visit novatech.net. That's novatech.net.
Habitat for Humanity's Legacy Point subdivision is making dreams come true.
It just does so much for the community when everyone can participate in home ownership. It builds stronger communities.
And you help build Habitat homes whenever you save at the Habitat Restore.
You know, that's a great investment for them, and it changes their life.
The Habitat Restore is at 850 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard. We're talking with Mary Ellen Evans. Why did you choose Adams Place?
Mostly based on a realization that I wouldn't find anything more beautiful. The architecture is superb, elegant, and the people are caring. The residents, they consider it one family. I mean, this is just an unbelievable combination of good things.
Hi, this is Terry Deal at Adams Place. Call me for more information about Adams Place. Phone 615-904-9111. Adam's Place.
This is Stan Vaught. I'm a lot like you, a husband, father, farmer, auctioneer, and community supporter. I'm now a candidate for school board. In the last cases, Walter Hill, Milton, Leanna, Oakland, and Siegel communities. I believe in community schools, vocational education, and getting education back to the basics. I'd appreciate your support for school board.
Early voting going on now through July 27th. Election day is August 1st. Paid for by Stan Vaught for school board, Stan Vaught treasurer.
Man on the Street Newsmakers, brought to you by Old National Bank in Murfreesboro.
Excited to announce that Capstar Bank is now officially a division of Old National Bank. All those friends you've made while banking here over the years, well, they're still there. And so are the delicious, warm, homemade cookies.
In Murfreesboro at 2230 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard.
Everything you enjoyed at Capstar, still there at Old National Bank. Old National Bank, ready to serve you.
Old National Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Now, information you need. Are there major risk factors of Alzheimer's disease and dementia that we need to be aware of?
If you have a biological parent that has the disease, if they're carrying that gene, you do have a 50-50% chance of getting the disease.
But the greatest risk are with...
People who smoke have a higher risk of forming Alzheimer's. People who drink alcohol have a higher risk of Alzheimer's. Exercise is a good way to lower your risk factor. Education is also a great way to lower your risk factor because you're exercising your brain. You're stretching it by learning.
And here's a shocker.
When we look at all of the counties, Rutherford County ranks third out of all the counties in the state where Alzheimer's is listed as the cause of death. Overall, Alzheimer's is the sixth leading cause of death in America. So more people die of Alzheimer's than they do of breast cancer and prostate cancer combined. Women have a higher risk of Alzheimer's than men. With men, they focused for the last at least 20 years on cardiovascular health, which were all risk factors we've already discussed for Alzheimer's. So by focusing on their cardiovascular health, they improve the risk factors for Alzheimer's.
And that's information you need about Alzheimer's disease and dementia.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
It's 6:48 here on The Crew. We've got weather coming up and news as well at the top of the hour. I want to continue our list of the Emmy nominations that has taken place. For Outstanding Lead Actress in a Limited or Anthology Series, Jodie Foster in True Detective, Night Country. I heard that was really good.
I haven't seen that one.
Brie Larson, Lessons in Chemistry, Juno Temple in Fargo, Sofia Vergara in Griselda. I didn't know she was in that. Naomi Watts, Feud for Capote versus the Swan.
Judo Temple, right?
Juno Temple, yeah.
She was really great in Fargo, too.
Outstanding Limited or Anthology Series, Baby Reindeer, Fargo, and Lessons in Chemistry. All right, I need to take this list home with me where I can watch some of these shows.
I think Fargo's probably going to clean up a lot. It was really highly acclaimed.
Ripley and True Detective also were in those nominations. Outstanding Lead Actress in Drama, Jennifer Aniston, Anna Sawai, Shogun, Carrie Coon, Imelda Staunton, The Crown, Maya Erskine in Mr. and Mrs. Smith, and Reese Witherspoon. So she and Jennifer are nominated for that.
That's for the morning show.
Outstanding Lead Actor in a Drama Series, Idris Elba for Hijack, Kuroyuki Sonata in Shogun, Walter Goggins. You remember Walton Goggins? I think Walter is actually what it is, in Fallout. Dominic West, he's been in several big-time shows, The Crown. Donald Glover, who we just heard do a record
Dalton,
the other day.
Yeah.
Mr. and Ms. Smith and Gary Oldham in Slow Horses.
Mr. and Ms. Smith is good, and Slow Horses is really good. That's on
Apple.
Well,
I love the movie.
Apple.
I love the movie, Mr. and Ms. Smith. Outstanding Drama Series, The Crown, Mr. and Ms. Smith, Fallout, Shogun, The Gilded Age, Slow Horses, The Morning Show, and Three Body Problem.
So Apple TV has Slow Horses and The Morning Show. So it's really kind of weird how, I mean, it's not just the big networks anymore.
No, I don't have Apple, so you can quit bragging. Outstanding Lead Actor in a Comedy Series, Matt Berry, What Do We Do in the Shadows? Larry David with Curb Your Enthusiasm. I'd say he'd have to be the favorite because this is his final season.
Probably.
Steve Martin, Only Murders in the Building, and along with Martin Short in that same. Jeremy Allen White for The Bear. DeFaro Wunotai in Reservation Dogs. An outstanding lead actress in the comedy series, Kenta Brunson, Abbott Elementary, Maya Rudolph in Loot. Ayo Edebiri, The Bear. Jean Smart for Hacks. You know, she's an older actress. She's always seems to be in some good stuff still. Selena Gomez, Only Murder in the Building, and Kristen Wiig for Palm Royale.
I haven't seen Every Murder in the Building, but it's got Martin Short, Steve Martin, and then Selena's in that.
Also on that outstanding lead actress list, as we keep going. No, wait a minute. I may have spoke too soon. Yeah, here's the outstanding comedy series.
Okay.
We've got a few more. Abbott Elementary. I love that show.
I haven't seen it.
Well, if you're a teacher, it's a good
show. Is it hit home?
The Bear, Curb Your Enthusiasm, Hacks, Only Murders in the Building, Palm Royale, Reservation Dogs, and What Do We Do in the Shadows? Outstanding supporting actor in a limited or anthology series or movie, Jonathan Bailey, Fellow Travelers, John Hawks in True Detective, Robert Downey Jr. in The Sympathizer.
Wow.
Lamorne Forrest in Fargo, Tom Goodman Hill in Baby Reindeer, Treat Williams, Feud, Capote versus the Swans, and one more we'll get in here. Outstanding supporting actress in a limited or series or movie, Dakota Fanning for Ripley, Lily Gladstone, Under the Bridge, Jessica Gunning, Baby Reindeer, Aja Naomi King in Lessons in Chemistry, Diane Lane, that's an old familiar name,
yeah.
Diane Lane from Feud, Capote versus the Swans, Nava Mao in Baby Reindeer, Kalee Reese in True Detective, and one more. Outstanding supporting actress in a drama series, Christine Baranski, The Gilded Age, Greta Lee, The Morning Show, Nicole Beharie in The Morning Show, Leslie Manville, The Crown, Elizabeth Debicki in The Crown, Karen Pittman, The Morning Show, Holland Taylor, The Morning Show. So it's racking up.
Yeah, it is.
So many.
A lot of nominations.
We've got a few more. I think you got time. Maybe you can do it over in the 7 o'clock hour.
Maybe
finish
we'll,
up.
Yeah.
All right. That's a look at the Emmy nominations coming up, and that'll be September 15th on ABC. Okay.
Indeed.
All right. Ready for some birthdays?
Sure.
It's birthday time. Because it's birthday time. What a day for celebrating. There'll be songs and gifts.
All right. George Bernard Shaw, born in 1856. Stanley Kubrick, great American director. 2001, A Space Odyssey, 1928. 1940, Dobie Gray, American musician and singer.
Ain't it a shame? Oh, give me the beat, boys, and free my soul. I wanna get lost in your rock and roll and drift away.
And in 1941, Brenton Wood, he's another great American rock musician.
Just give me some kind of sign, girl. Oh, my baby, to show me that you're mine.
And continuing the singing theme, 1943, Mick Jagger of the Rolling Stones.
Nice to meet you. Hope you get my name.
That would make him 80, wouldn't it?
I think that's right, yeah.
In 1945, Helen Mirren, actress. 1956, Dorothy Hamill. 1964, Sandra Bullock. And in 1967, Jason Statham. Of course, he's in all those Transporter movies. Mm. And that's a look at celebrity birthdays. Today, Dr. Carl Vinson, Jeff Sanders, Sheila McDaniel, Janice Bug, Marty Key, Leslie Fair, Susan Lloyd, Gretchen Thomas, Deborah Marshall, and Nikki Carlin have birthdays. Tomorrow, Bill Shacklett, Robbie Robinson, Ed Hardison, Kevin Fortner, Donnie Hensley, and Brent Tempton.
So those are the names we have on the list so far. If you want to add birthdays for today or tomorrow, call 615-893-1450. You can also text us and leave us a message on the Slick Pig Barbecue Birthday Club. And today's holiday, it's National Bagel Fest Day.
Checking your Rutherford County weather. Patchy fog possible in spots early today. Otherwise, plenty of cloudiness, showers, and storms in the area. Highs top out near 87 degrees. Winds south around 5 miles per hour. And then tonight, any showers and storms end early. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. Patchy fog could redevelop in spots well after midnight, with lows dropping to 70. I'm weatherology meteorologist Phil Jenska with your Wake Up Crew forecast. Right now it's 73.
Everywhere you go in this area, you see beautiful brick mailboxes from LaGreen's Masonry. Visit their website and see their variety. LaGreen'sMasonry.com, a family business you can trust. LaGreen's Masonry.
Good morning. Wrapping up the paperwork on the earlier wreck there at Donaldson Pike at I-40. We could get wet there on 65 coming up through certain parts of Murray County, Williamson County, just south of Nashville. I see some rain showers down through there. It could affect your drive on 65. Be careful as it builds now on I-40 coming in from Wilson County. 24 is loading up out of Murfreesboro headed towards the Antioch area. Nash Painting, a non-franchise painting company, mentioned this ad. Get a discount, 912-2288. I'm Commander Chuck with your on-time traffic.
Hi, this is Gator with Tire World Off-Road. We are your local Rough Country dealer. So when you're ready to add some character to your rig, ask for Gator at Tire World Off-Road on Memorial Boulevard.
This is Sean Brown at Tire World on Broad Street. Online at tireworld.us.
Here's a question. What do you want from your electric co-op?
I want expert advice on going 100% solar.
I want to go green without breaking the bank.
I want to meet my sustainability goals.
I want solar to be simple.
Done, 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 done.
I want to save the planet.
Little hero, let's start with one of MTE's solar programs first. Energy Service Life. That's Middle Tennessee Electric. We're here to get done what matters most to you. Learn more at mte.com.
You know the value of a good neighbor, someone you can trust, someone who looks out for you. And when it comes to Medicare, it's good to have someone on your side. That's where Senior Financial Group comes in. We're Tennesseans, just like you. And we've partnered with United Healthcare, a trusted name in health insurance. Together, we'll guide you through your Medicare options. We will compare plans, answer your questions, and ensure you get the most of your Medicare benefits with United Healthcare. Don't navigate Medicare alone. Call Senior Financial Group at 800-690-0251 or visit sfgmedicare.com for a free plan review today.
Families love Adams Place.
My daughter kept telling me that she wanted me to come to Adams Place. And I came here to look at the rooms. I decided to stay. And I'm not one bit sorry because I've been very well taken care of. And I have been very happy that I did come to Adams Place.
Hi, this is Terry Deal at Adams Place. Call me for more information about Adams Place. Phone 615-904-9111. Adams Place.
This is Stan Vaught. I'm a lot like you, a husband, father, farmer, auctioneer, and community supporter. I'm now a candidate for school board in the Las Casas, Walter Hill, Milton, Leanna, Oakland, and Sigel communities. I believe in community schools, vocational education, and getting education back to the basics. I'd appreciate your support for school board.
Early voting going on now through July 27th. Election day is August 1st. Paid for by Stan Vaught for school board, Stan Vaught treasurer.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
6:58 here on The Wake Up Crew, and glad you're with us. Brooke Walker is today's good neighbor of the day for being there in an eye emergency. Brooke's going to receive flowers from Jenny Harrison and the family over at Ryan Flowers Coffee and Gifts and News Radio WGNS.
So if you'd like to send in a Good Neighbor of the Day nomination, we've made it simple and have given you multiple ways to do that. Text neighbor to 615-893-1450. And then when you get the reply from us on your phone, just tap on that link, fill out the info. When you're done, click submit, and it's going to take you 2 minutes tops, and you'll make someone's day for sure. You can get to that same web form at WGNSradio.com/goodneighbor. You can also mail it to us or even call this afternoon and leave that message with Melissa there. Birthdays and anniversaries, don't forget, send those in. 615-893-1450. Slick Pig Barbecue Birthday Club lines open for another 30 minutes or so. World News next on WGNS.
This is John Day of the Law Offices of John Day. We want to make a difference in the community we hold so dear. If you're ever injured, know that we are here for you too. Call the Law Offices of John Day.
News is next. Stay with us.
Portions of our programming have been pre-recorded.
The Good Neighbor Network, WGNS, Murfreesboro, Smyrna, flagship station for MTSU sports. Courthouse clock time, 7 o'clock.
Obama backs Harris.
Michelle and I couldn't be prouder to endorse you.
Western wildfire.
Crews are working overhead and on the ground.
Major drug bust.
Two more alleged leaders of the Sinaloa cartel.
Good morning. I'm Steve Kerr. Chafin. With the CBS World News Roundup, former President Obama and wife Michelle have thrown their support behind Vice President Kamala Harris. CBS's Ed O'Keefe reports it caps a week of fast-moving campaign developments launched by President Biden's decision to leave the race.
This is going to be historic.
This morning, another big endorsement for Vice President Harris is in.
We called to say Michelle and I couldn't be prouder to endorse you and to do everything we can to get you through this election and into the Oval Office.
The official nod from the Obamas comes as Harris made clear she expects to see former President Donald Trump soon on a debate stage.
I'm ready to debate Donald Trump. I have agreed to the previously agreed upon September 10th debate. He agreed to that previously. Now it appears he's backpedaling, but I'm ready.
In a statement late Thursday, the Trump campaign said debate details cannot be finalized until Democrats formally decide on their nominee.
There's been a massive escalation of wildfires in the West. CBS's Jonathan Vigliotti has more on the destruction in and around Chico, California.
Explosions from the raging park fire sent fire crews running for safety. The barely contained blaze started Wednesday and surged in size, engulfing structures and vehicles. Investigators believe the fire was started by 42-year-old Ronnie Stout, who witnesses say pushed a flaming car down a 60-foot embankment.
And then he got out of the car, kind of looked at it. When I turned back, he was gone.
He's now in custody facing arson charges. The fire has forced thousands to evacuate, and some residents are now returning home to rubble.
This is the last of my home.
Julia Yarbo witnessed her dream home burn down in real time through her security camera.
I think I might be in shock. It's surreal.
That scene is 20 miles from Paradise, California, where 85 people died in a destructive fire in 2018. People there now are on standby to evacuate. Now to Western Canada, CBS's Carter Evans has more on the fast-moving fire that's ravaged the resort town of Jasper, Alberta.
This is one of more than 900 wildfires that are burning in Canada right now, but this one, it is particularly hard as Jasper was considered the jewel of the national park system here. A Canadian colleague told me it's the equivalent of Yosemite or Yellowstone, and Alberta's premier fought back tears while promising to rebuild.
To those in Alberta and around the world who have experience the magic of Jasper. The magic is not lost, and it never will be.
A man considered one of the most notorious drug traffickers in the world is in U.S. custody. Ismael Almayo Zambada, closely tied with the imprisoned El Chapo Guzman, was arrested, along with El Chapo's son. Attorney General Merrick Garland says they're key players in the Sinaloa cartel.
Both men are facing multiple charges in the United States for leading the cartel's criminal operations, including its deadly drug manufacturing and trafficking networks.
The U.S. government had been offering a $15 million reward for information leading to Zambada's arrest. Overseas, arson attacks have hit the French National Rail Company's high-speed lines hours before the official opening of the Paris Olympics.
The rail company SNCF says several fires were set and that rail lines in the west, north, and east of France are affected, as well as to Belgium and London under the English Channel. Eurostar says there are cancellations and delays and is telling travelers to change their trips. Wendy Gillette, CBS News, Paris.
As CBS's Elaine Cobb tells us, the weather is an issue in the French capital.
It's raining in Paris, and the weather service says it will rain again tonight for the duration of the outdoor opening ceremony along the Seine River. The rain also increases doubts about the swimming events planned for the Seine. When it rains heavily, wastewater and runoff from upstream flood into the river, making it unsafe.
It's the Friday morning World News Roundup, and it's 4 minutes after the hour.
Think O'Reilly Auto Parts for all your car care needs. Get the parts and service you need fast from the professional parts people at O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Have you Googled yourself lately? Are there negative posts from an ex-employee or from a former client? Maybe an outdated news article or sensitive personal information about your family? Search engines don't always get it right. But right or wrong, it's your reputation on the line. That's where Reputation Defender by Norton comes in. One of the most trusted names in online reputation repair. Reputation Defender has been fixing people's search results for over 15 years. Their cutting-edge approaches help you to wipe away unwanted information in your search results. They also promote the good stuff so that it rises to the top, helping you put your best foot forward. Your good name is too valuable to leave to the whims of a Google algorithm. Take control with Reputation Defender. You can start by getting your free reputation report card at ReputationDefender.com or call 800-401-6681 to speak to an expert. That's 800-401-6681.
A busy string of meetings for Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu as he rallies support in the U.S. for the Gaza war effort. First, President Biden yesterday, then Vice President Harris.
I remain committed to a path forward that can lead to a two-state solution.
Today, as we hear from CBS's Michael Toscano, he visits Donald Trump.
The meeting will take place at the former president's home at Mar-a-Lago in Florida, their first face-to-face since Trump was in the White House. As prime minister and president, the two men developed a close relationship, but Trump soured on Netanyahu when he was the first world leader to personally congratulate President Biden on his 2020 victory.
New questions about the assassination attempt on former President Trump. CBS's Scott McFarlane reports they've opened up a new avenue of political disagreement.
The day after FBI Director Christopher Wray raised questions about whether Trump was actually hit by a bullet.
There's some question about whether or not a bullet or shrapnel that hit his ear.
Democrats pounced.
If he's lying about whether he was actually shot, that's something that the American people should know.
The only medical statement released about Trump's injury wasn't from the hospital that treated him, but by his political ally and former White House doctor, Ronnie Jackson.
If it wasn't a bullet wound, I ask you, what was it? Piece of glass? Where'd the glass come from? I've been told the teleprompters are completely intact.
The Falcon 9 rocket from SpaceX has been cleared for launch next month. 2 weeks ago, it suffered a problem in a second stage booster, failing to deploy 20 Starlink satellites that eventually burned up in the atmosphere. Today is the 34th anniversary of the Americans with Disabilities Act. A congresswoman spoke about it on the House floor yesterday.
I was in college when it passed in 1990. Today, an entire generation has never known life without the protections that exist because of the ADA.
Virginia's Jennifer Wexton making history, delivering the first speech from Congress using a voice cloned by artificial intelligence. She was diagnosed last year with a rare neurological disorder that robbed her of the ability to speak clearly. Billy Joel's long residency at New York's Madison Square Garden is over. The piano man's two young daughters joined him on stage for that song. It ends with his 150th show at the Garden. The residency began in 2013. Time on the roundup, 8 past the hour.
Sorry, but we actually have a wait list for our Monstera.
Shaw's greenhouse is really bringing in the green.
We can't keep snake plants and stuff.
She needs a construction manager to build on her roots and grow.
We could add a whole section for ferns. Here we'd have dahlias, dahlias, and more dahlias.
Indeed can help her hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. You can schedule and conduct virtual interviews all from your employer dashboard. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
eBay Motors is here for the ride. Go ahead, feel your engine. Admire that perfectly installed exhaust. Your vehicle's moving along this freeway like it was made from fresh installs and a whole lot of love. With eBay Motors, you get over 122 million parts to keep it running. And with eBay Guaranteed Fit, they'll be the perfect fit every time. Plus at these prices, well, we're burning rubber, not cash. Keep your ride or die alive at ebaymotors.com. Eligible items only, exclusions apply.
I'm Steve Kathan, CBS News Radio. We'll have updates at the top of every hour all day long. Now, here are Brian Barrett, John Dinkins, and Dalton Barrett.
Thanks, Steve. I'm Brian Barrett, joined by John Dinkins and Dalton Barrett. It's the second hour of the Wake Up Crew here this morning, straight ahead. Also, a check of traffic and weather together. This update is brought to you by locally owned and operated Toots.
Make one of our Rutherford County locations your pre- or post-voting spot. Stop by Toots and make sure you get out and vote.
Toots.
This is Nick Hayes with Toots Restaurants, reminding you to get out and vote and stop by one of our locations for a $6.99 lunch special afterwards.
Hi, this is Wade Hayes of Toots Restaurants. It's an election year, so it's very important that you get out and vote. Right, Jack?
Yep. It's real important that everyone gets out and vote this year.
Good food and fun.
Checking your Rutherford County weather. Patchy fog possible in spots early today. Otherwise, plenty of cloudiness, showers, and storms in the area. Highs top out near 87 degrees. Winds south around 5 miles per hour. And then tonight, any showers and storms, and early, Otherwise, mostly cloudy, patchy fog could redevelop in spots well after midnight, with lows dropping to 70. I'm weatherology meteorologist Phil Jenska with your Wake Up Crew forecast. Right now it's 73.
We're excited to announce that Capstar Bank is now officially a division of Old National Bank. Old National Bank in Murfreesboro at 2230 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard. Old National Bank, ready to serve you.
Old National Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Good morning. Still wrapping up a couple of wrecks we had out here a little bit earlier. It's starting to build pretty good on 65 right now in the rain there. Coming up through certain parts of Murray County, Williamson County on 65 up through Spring Hill. Be careful. Again, a lot of rain looks like it's moving in from the south. Southwest towards Middle Tennessee. Traffic's on the increase out here. I-40 coming in from Wilson County. Princess Hot Chicken now offers DoorDash, Uber Eats delivery. Order online this weekend with that new menu at princesshotchicken.com. I'm Commander Chuck with your on-time traffic.
Hi, this is Ryan with Tire World Laverne, here to serve all your automotive needs in Rutherford County. We welcome all your fleet and commercial accounts, along with all your regular routine maintenance. Tire World, a hometown family business you can trust.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
This is The Wake Up Crew on News Radio WGNS.
So no one told you life was gonna be this way. When it hasn't been your day, your week, your month, or even your year, but
John Dinkins, Brian Barrett, and Dalton Barrett.
It is hour number two of the Wake Up Crew, Friday morning, wrapping up the week, July 26th. You got tax-free weekend. You got a lot of shopping to do, maybe. And 12 days from the start of school, it'll be on Wednesday, August the 7th. So right around the corner, Brian and John here with you on a finally Friday.
It's Friday.
Yeah, we have made it to the end of the week, and you know, later on, maybe you're planning on a, you know, lazy weekend at home. Who knows? But thought during some of our segment here, some binge-worthy shows that are perfect for a lazy weekend. Coming up here in a few minutes. We're going to finish our Emmy nominee
That's
list.
That's what I thought.
Well, I'm talking about later.
Oh.
Yeah. And then, of course, what we're watching, kind of trivia and all that kind of
We're going to do
stuff.
That still?
Yeah.
Have you watched something?
I don't know. 1, 2, 3, 7 pages.
Oh, my Lord.
I haven't gotten to a lot of
Do I have to even be present for this that portion of the program? Can I just, like, go take a break?
Yeah. Or? Okay. We'll see. All right. Song of the day.
Oh.
Let's get that in here. This is the number one song from the year 1985, and it's the second appearance in the top five in 1985 for Wham. They had the third biggest song with Wake Me Up Before You Go-Go, which I like better than this one myself. But this
What about
is,
Faith? Was that a year before or something?
It must have been before or after. Yeah. But this is the biggest song of 1985.
I'm never gonna dance again. Guilty feet have got no rhythm. But it's easy to pretend. I know you're not a fool.
George Michael. Part of Wham. This was pre On Your Own, right? This was before he went out on his own.
Yeah. It may have been the last big hit for him. He wasn't with them but about 2 years.
Yeah, it was a very short time.
I did tell you about that movie with Hugh Grant. You've got to watch it. You don't like romantic comedies, but he is so good in that. And they do a parody of Wham because it was like a story of a guy that was in a group like Wham and his career. It's like he's the other guy. The other guy got real famous, and he's the other guy, and it's really good.
So what? Which?
Drew Barrymore's in it.
Music and lyrics.
Yes. Okay. Yes, that is a great, great movie. If you like parodies of Wham in the 80s, if you only watch the first 15 minutes of the movie, it's worth watching. Then you don't have to watch the rest of it.
Oh, just the first little bit?
Just to see him do that. I imagine that you can look it up on probably your computer and see part of that.
Probably on YouTube, the first part of it.
It's really great.
So you're going to finish up our list.
Is that what I'm watching? Okay, I can count that with what I'm watching. Yeah. Okay.
You can, let's see, what are we doing? Oh, yeah, the rest of the Emmy list. We went over a lot of it in the 6 o'clock hour. We had a few leftovers.
Yeah, we've got a few. Outstanding Supporting Actor in a Drama Series. Tanenobu Asano. Is that why you didn't want to read this? Shogun. Billy Crudup, who is, to me, one of the most underrated actors ever. He is fabulous in everything he does. Mark Duplass, who is another underrated actor. He's in The Morning Show, and he's also an excellent writer. He writes stuff.
And so is... we were just talking about
Billy Crudup.
Yeah, he's also in The Morning Show.
Yeah. John Hamm, The Morning Show. I didn't even know he was in The Morning Show.
He was the last season. He did that in Fargo.
Man, he's been popular, hasn't he?
He has.
Takahiro Hira in Shogun. Jack Loudon, Slow Horses. Jonathan Pryce, The Crown. And Outstanding Supporting Actor in a Comedy Series, Lionel Boyce, The Bear. I got a feeling The Bear is going to get some picks.
I think you're right.
Paul Rudd, Only Murders in the Building.
Paul, I didn't know he was in there.
Paul W. Downs in Hacks. Tyler James Williams, Abbott Elementary. Eben Moss Bachrach in The Bear. Bowen Yang in Saturday Night Live. Wow, Saturday Night Live guy. Outstanding Supporting Actress in the Comedy Series. This just baffled me. Carol Burnett in Palm Royale. Carol Burnett's 90.
I know.
And
apparently she was good in it. I haven't watched it. But.
Liza Colon-Hazayas in The Bear. Hannah Einbinder in Hacks. Janelle James in Abbott Elementary, Cheryl Lee Roth, The Bear, Meryl Streep, Only Murders in the Building. Have you noticed the Emmy Awards are strictly, there's not a lot of network stuff in here.
Not a whole lot. No. Abbott Elementary is one that's been mentioned
most. That's about it. Yeah. Yeah. You know, Chicago PD's not in it? Okay.
Apparently
anyway,
not.
Blue Eye Samurai, the outstanding animated program, Bob's Burgers. Scavenger's Reign. I don't watch animated. So
I don't either.
The Simpsons, X-Men 97. Outstanding television movie, Mr. Monk's Last Case, a Monk movie.
Interesting.
They just did that. Red, White, and Royal Blue, and Quiz Lady. Let's see what else.
You can watch all of Monk on Netflix, I think.
Yeah, man. Scoop and Unfrosted. That's the, I think Unfrosted, isn't that the Jerry Seinfeld thing?
Yeah, that's about Pop-Tarts and whatever came out at the same time, yeah.
Outstanding guest actress in a drama series, Michaela Cole in Mr. and Ms. Smith, Claire Foy, The Crown, Marcia Gay Harden in The Morning Show, Sarah Paulson, Mr. and Ms. Smith, Parker Posey, Mr. and Ms. Smith. Outstanding great actor in a drama series. Do I have enough time here? Let me see. We'll skip that and go to outstanding guest actress, Olivia Colman in The Bear, Divine Joy Randolph, Only Murders in the Building, Jamie Lee Curtis is in The Bear. Maya Rudolph, Saturday Night Live. These are like one appearances, you know, like brief appearances. Kristen Wiig, Saturday Night Live, and Caitlin Olsen in Hacks. And finally, Outstanding Guest Actor in a Comedy Series, John Bernthal in The Bear, Matthew Broderick, Only Murders in the Building, Ryan Gosling, Saturday Night Live, and boy, if you haven't seen that one,
it's a good one.
It is great. Bob Odenkirk, The Bear, and Will Poulter, The Bear. That'll be September 15th, 8 o'clock on ABC.
So Jamie Lee Curtis plays the mom in The Bear. So she's got a really good part in that. Okay, more of what we're watching after sports.
This is News Radio WGNS, Primetime Sports.
Sponsored by the law offices of John Day.
From the Fox Sports studios in Los Angeles. Here's Eddie Garcia.
In Major League Baseball games of note, the Padres shut out the Nationals in D.C. 3-0. The story of this one, though, San Diego starting pitcher Dylan Cease, 9 innings, no runs, no hits, 9 strikeouts, 3 walks, 114 pitches. He throws the second no-hitter in Padres franchise history. With the win, San Diego is now a half game in front of idle St. Louis for the final wildcard spot in the National League. Dodgers defeat the Giants 6-4. LA's Clayton Kershaw made his season debut coming back from shoulder surgery through 72 pitches, lasted 4 innings, 2 runs, 5 hits, 6 strikeouts, 2 walks in a no decision. Shohei Ohtani hit his 31st homer of the year as the NL West leaders took 3-4 in the series from San Francisco. Guardians, the AL Central leaders, shut out by the Tigers 3-0. Orioles had a 6-0 lead, end up getting a 7-6 win over the Marlins in 10 innings to move 2 games up on the idle New York Yankees atop the AL East. Mets over the Braves 3-2 in 10 innings. New York a half game back of Atlanta for the number 1 wildcard spot in the National League.
Welcome to Danny Brewer's Friday Pony Picks, sponsored by the Mint Gaming Hall at Kentucky Downs. Another glorious Kentucky Derby is now in the books, but the action in this game is just getting out of the gates. Make plans now to attend the live racing meet at Kentucky Downs. Beginning August 29th and finishing September 11th, seven different dates will feature a plethora of stakes races and the highest per race purse payouts in the United States. For more info, visit themintgaming.com.
Danny Brewer here. Saturday, July 27th, big day of racing on both coasts. Saratoga, that's where we begin. Race 6, the Grade 1 Alfred G. Vanderbilt. 6 furlongs on the dirt for 3-year-olds and up. Your guaranteed ticket cash for the day is the number 6, Skelly, across the board. Steve Asmussen, trainee, has 10 wins in 5 seconds and 16 career starts. Our price play in this race is the number 4, Baby Yoda. Trained by Bill Mott, he's won 2 in a row. Race 10, the Grade 2 Jim Dandy. Mile and the eighth on dirt for 3-year-old males, a stacked 6-horse field here. Even money favorite Sierra Leone will be closing at the end, while the 9-5 second choice Fierceness hopes to seal it on the front end. Because all the favorites have fallen short in the big 3-year-old events this year, we like the number 5, Ghoul's Gold. Son of Golden Sense is 15-1 on the morning line. Next, let's head to Del Mar. Race 8, the Grade 2 San Diego. Mile and 16th on the dirt for older males. The number 4, Arabian Knight, trained by Bob Baffert. He's coming in off a layoff, but he won his only start at the Seaside Oval. We're going to finish today, race 10, the Grade 1 Bing Crosby. Race of the day, by far, $400,000, 6 furlongs on dirt for 3-year-olds and up. Loaded 9-horse field, that means superfecta box. Our top pick is the number 8, the Chosen Braun. He's a winning machine. We also like the number 7, Happy Jack, for trainer Doug O'Neill. The number 9, Jackstown, trained by Bob Baffert. The number 1, Anarchist, completes it. Also trained by Doug O'Neill. Got a hunch, bet a bunch, back a horse and get paid.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With Brian Barrett, John Dinkins, and Dalton Barrett.
7:22 is the time. Wake Up Crew is the program on a Friday morning. At this time, we usually like to share with you what we're watching.
Meet the Flintstones.
Alrighty, what we're watching. John is going to give me the floor here for a little bit, because there have been several things, and we haven't really, we've done some other things instead of just all about what we're watching. And if you want to get ready for the high school football season, there is, where did I watch this? On Paramount, I think. It could have been Max. Maybe it was Max. But anyway, either one. BS High School. It's about a high school team that, and I believe it was one of the northern states. And this high school that really didn't, these kids weren't in school. There was no school. They played a football season or two. It really interesting how all of that came about. Kind of a documentary type of thing. Dalton mentioned earlier this week Bullet Train. I watched Bullet Train. It is not like John Wick as much, I don't think. I liked it okay, but I think Dalton enjoyed it a little bit more than me. But Bullet Train is on Hulu if you'd like to watch that. With the
He said he loved Bullet Train.
He said he loved it. I watched it. It was okay. It was okay. I liked it okay.
Oh, wow.
It wasn't the same action as John Wick movies, for sure.
Wait till Monday comes.
Yeah. Also on Netflix, it's kind of a it's kind of a modern war movie. It's called The Land of the Bad. They go into this, I've forgotten the actor's name now. His brother is Thor.
Hemsworth?
Yeah, his younger brother.
He's
the main character in that. So,
what's his name?
Oh, I want to say Liam, but it.
That's right. I think that may be
Liam
right.
Liam Hemsworth, maybe. So it's a pretty good watch, about 2 hours there. Also watched this movie based on a true story about a golf team, high school golf team that was created at this school. And
oh, I did see that.
The long game.
Mm-hmm. I saw that.
And
obstacles that they had.
Yeah. I thought it was a really, really good movie.
My favorite actor's in that. What's his name? He was in Magnum, wasn't he?
Yes, he was Magnum.
Yeah.
In the new Magnum. I can't remember his name. But
Rodriguez is his last name. Yeah. I know that. Maybe. I'm thinking Adam, maybe.
And what's his name that's going to be in the Reagan movie?
Quaid.
Yeah, Dennis Quaid.
Are you looking forward to that? I'm kind of looking forward to Reagan movie.
I think he's cast pretty well. Yeah. I mean, if you kind of look at him that way. So we'll see.
Well, he is Republican, too, I think.
Dennis Quaid?
Yeah. Or he's voting for Trump, I think.
Yeah.
Well,
on that note, I did watch Hillbilly Elegy.
Yeah. Oh, really?
It's based off of the book by J.D. Vance, and it was about his life and growing up. And it was a really good movie. Glenn Close played the grandmother, and I told Dalton that the grandmother reminds me a lot of his grandfather. You know,
Was that Virginia?
They were in Kentucky, and they moved to Middletown, Ohio.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Amy Adams, who was in the Superman movie, played the mom in that, and thought it was it's a really good story. So, and the only other thing I have here is The Bear, but I've had that for a while.
You haven't watched it yet?
I have watched all of The Bear.
And what did you think?
All three seasons. I like The Bear.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, you were kind of off air. You were kind of like slamming it a little bit.
Well, no, I just thought that was a lot of Emmy nominations for The Bear. I was surprised.
So, Abbott Elementary or The Bear? Which one are you picking?
I haven't seen Abbott Elementary.
Oh.
At all.
Morning Show and The Bear. Which one are you picking?
I like The Morning Show better myself. Okay. Fargo, I probably liked it the best of all of them.
Yeah, I guess I'll need to check that out. Is that on Apple? Where's Fargo?
It's Fargo is
Paramount?
Hulu, I think.
Hulu.
Yeah.
Okay.
You been checking out anything?
I watch news and that kind of thing.
Do you?
I'm pretty much, you know.
I see.
Above just watching, you know, entertainment.
We had talked a little bit about Kevin Costner's movie Horizon, that Western that was going to be in two parts in July and then in August. Well, the first part did not do very well.
Uh-oh.
So part two will not hit theaters on August 16th, apparently. They were going to release one just
a
few weeks apart. And the first part did not, I think, maybe $23 million in the first 2 weeks. And I'm pretty sure Kevin Costner put in about $30 million of his own money to make this two-part Western. So I don't know.
Well, got to look at it this way. He's got it.
Well, yeah.
You know, but...
And maybe it does really well on streaming somewhere. I'm sure they'll put it somewhere. So, there you go. That's a little what we're watching today.
This is a paid legal ad.
When a family member is lost as a result of someone else's negligence, the grief can be unbearable. It also leaves you with a lot of questions like, how did this happen? Who's responsible? And is my family going to be okay? That's a lot to go through, but with the law offices of John Day on your side, you don't have to go through any of it alone. We understand what you're going through, and we have the experience to get the answers, justice, and compensation your family deserves. Call the law offices of John Day.
Is your saving for retirement strategy involving the phrase, I'll get around to it someday? If so, we need to talk. Hi, I'm Edward Jones Financial Advisor Lee Colvin, and when it comes to meeting your goals, time can be on your side. And there's no better time than now to get started towards your retirement goals. Give us a call, Lee Colvin, at 615-907-7056. Edward Jones, Making Sense of Investing, member SIPC.
Meet new friends and have fun at the Villages of Murfreesboro.
They have a lot of trips they take to different places, which is good, and they go out a lot, about once a month, I would say, at least, to a different restaurant to eat lunch. So they have a lot of extra activities here that you can do.
I'm Hope Rogers. Call me at the Villages of Murfreesboro, 615-848-3030.
The staff here is just wonderful. You can't compare it with any other place.
I'm Rodney French from French's Shoes and Boots in Murfreesboro. I'd like to invite you over to our hometown store, 1837 South Church Street. French's Shoes and Boots has been serving Rutherford County with the best selection of work boots, western boots, and a great selection of shoes and accessories. Our bargain room is full of famous brand shoes and boots up to 90% off mall prices. Brands like Clark's, Merrill, Justin, and Ariat. Tons of shoes and tons of brands, all at super great prices.
French's Shoes and Boots.
1837 South Church Street in Murfreesboro.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With Brian Barrett, John Dinkins, and Dalton Barrett.
Moving along here on a Friday morning, July 26th. It's episode 1457 of The Wake Up Crew.
And a lot of birthdays today. Dr. Carl Vinson has one today, along with Jeff Sanders, Sheila McDaniel, Janice Bug, Marty Key, Leslie Fares, Sudan Lloyd, Gretchen Thomas, Deborah Marshall, and Nikki Carlin. Tomorrow, Bill Shacklett, Robbie Robinson, Ed Hardison, Kevin Fortner, Donnie Hensley, and Bryn Tempton have birthdays.
Those are the birthdays that we had coming into the morning. If you've called or text in this morning, we'll announce those here in a half an hour. If you haven't had the chance to do so, now's the time. Slick Pig Barbecue birthday lines will close up here in a couple of seconds. Checking local news, traffic, and weather for you now.
For more than 30 years, my team and I have worked hard to help injured people throughout Middle Tennessee. Over that time, we've helped thousands of people get the legal help they need when they've needed it the most. Seriously injured? Call the law offices of John Day.
Checking your Rutherford County weather. Patchy fog possible in spots early today. Otherwise, plenty of cloudiness, showers, and storms in the area. Highs top out near 87 degrees. Wind south around 5 miles per hour. And then tonight, any showers and storms end early. Otherwise, mostly cloudy. Patchy fog could redevelop in spots well after midnight, with lows dropping to 70. I'm weatherology meteorologist Phil Jensko with your Wake Up Crew forecast. Right now it's 73.
Good morning. Wrapping up the paperwork on this wreck that's been out here for a while. South Nashville, 65 southbound there at Armory. It's building pretty good now through the Mount Juliet area. It's finally picking up, leaving Wilson County on 40, going westbound to Hermitage into Donelson as it starts to slow down a bit here on 65 southbound at Trinity Lane. Still see some rain showers. You could drive right into south of Nashville on 65 down through certain parts of Williamson County. Prince's Hot Chicken has new items on the menu. Prince's Hot Chicken. I'm Commander Chuck, your on-time traffic.
Now, an update from the WGNSRadio.com News Center.
I'm Ron Jordan. Early voting in Tennessee is officially underway, but turnout is not as strong as it was back in 2020. As of Wednesday, 242,357 votes were cast early. That is 186,874 fewer than compared to the same time in 2020. An early 44% decrease. As of Tuesday, early voting turnout was almost 20% lower compared to 2020. The Coffee County Sheriff's Office has arrested a man in connection with the killing of a man at a home in Beech Grove on Wednesday. 37-year-old Thomas Anthony was a passenger in a vehicle in Manchester when he allegedly had a confrontation that led to shots being fired into a truck he was in. 40-year-old Philip Lee Meadows was identified as the shooter. He is in jail facing first-degree murder charges. A 22-year-old faces multiple criminal charges, including vehicular homicide by intoxication, in connection with a fatal car crash that killed her boyfriend the day after Christmas. The Tennessee Highway Patrol says Shakira Serenity Madrigal was driving north on I-65 when she lost control of her boyfriend Cade Warren's vehicle and hit a guardrail. The report states that the impact caused the guardrail to penetrate the passenger side door, killing Warren. The couple was reportedly traveling back to Michigan from Alabama after visiting Warren's mother when the accident happened. In June, a Williamson County grand jury indicted Madrigal on 4 charges of vehicular homicide by intoxication, 2 counts of ruckus endangerment with a deadly weapon, and driving under the influence. She was initially arrested in Michigan and later extradited to Tennessee. I'm Ron Jordan reporting.
The Good Neighbor Network, on air and online at WGNSradio.com. Rutherford County's most trusted source for local news.
Are you shopping for lights?
We got it!
Doors?
We got it!
Flooring?
We got it!
Furniture?
We got it, here at the Habitat Restore. 850 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard in Murfreesboro.
Remember, we got it today, but it may be gone tomorrow.
Find it at the Restore, yeah. We got it at the Habitat Restore.
The Habitat Restore at 850 Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Boulevard in Murfreesboro.
Bob Ferris lives at Adams Place.
The personnel here are excellent, and they are concerned about your well-being. Yes, they're always asking you how you're doing and what can I do to help you, and that's a blessing.
Hi, this is Terry Deal at Adams Place. Call me for more information about Adams Place. Phone 615-904-9111. Adams Place, 1927 Memorial Boulevard, across from Walmart.
At Middle Point Landfill, we strive to serve our neighbors.
This county is willing to put themselves out there and take some new initiatives.
Mike Clausen, General Manager of the Middle Point Landfill.
We want to transform Middle Point into a sustainability campus where we are building recycling facilities. We're building cutting-edge diversion facilities.
Middle Point values its relationship with you, which is why we never tire of serving our neighbors throughout Rutherford County.
Learn more at MiddlePointLandfill.com.
The Wake Up Crew. WGNS.
With Brian Barrett, John Dinkins, and Dalton Barrett.
It's 7:35 here from the Wake Up Crew on News Radio WGNS, and we are going to share with you right now some binge-worthy shows that are perfect for a lazy weekend. Coming in on this list of binge-worthy shows is the comedy The Office. Nine seasons. Yeah. Of The Office.
It's good to watch a binge watch 30-minute shows, because if you watch them without commercials,
they're like 20 minutes.
Yeah, you can get them by pretty fast.
Yeah. Created by Ricky Gervais. Lost. Six seasons of Lost from 2004.
I can't go through that again.
Not a fan?
Never could understand it. Call me stupid, but I just never did.
Yeah, it was weird. J.J. Abrams created Lost. Let's see. How about Game of Thrones from 2011? Eight seasons of Game of Thrones.
That would be good to watch.
It's sci-fi. You're not really a sci-fi guy, though. I haven't watched Game of Thrones. Maybe I will. Stranger Things from 2016.
I have watched a little of it.
I haven't watched it either.
I don't know why I got distracted, but I didn't watch any more of it. But it's pretty good.
Four seasons.
That's still going on, isn't it? I think got one more year.
Maybe. Breaking Bad from 2008.
Ugh, well, that's another good one.
Have you finished it yet?
Well, I had watched it originally the first time.
Oh, I didn't.
But
know
I didn't.
That.
I didn't. It was kind of half and half. You know, I didn't quite. So I didn't watch. I tried to start it again. Got distracted. But you got to stay right with that thing. I mean, yeah. You can't, and you don't give up on it on the first one. You know, you got to keep going.
And it's one of those that really kind of rolls from one to the other pretty quick. Bryan Cranston, Aaron Paul, Anna Gunn in that.
He is absolutely tremendous in that.
Bryan Cranston, he's really good in everything that I've seen. I don't know that he's done a whole lot that hasn't been great.
But will he be remembered for Malcolm in the Middle or Breaking Bad?
Probably Breaking Bad.
He was good in Malcolm in the Middle.
He really was. Seven seasons of Veep from 2012. I tried to watch that. It's got
I love that.
Julia Louis-Dreyfus
show.
Did you?
Yes, it's great.
Did you watch it all?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Never missed an episode.
Well, maybe I need to give it another
try. I recommend that highly.
Highly recommended, huh?
Mm-hmm.
From 2018, Succession.
I never watched it. You did, but I never watched it.
It's got some really good acting in it. Four seasons of Succession that was on HBO, or I guess Max now.
It's got the Home Alone brother in it.
Yes. Well, it's the brother of Macaulay Culkin.
Right.
It's yeah,
the Home
yeah.
Alone brother?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I thought you meant like the brother that played in Home Alone.
No, the Home Alone guy, brother.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is, the language is pretty strong in it. It is TV mature.
It is in Veep, too.
Yeah, a lot of these, actually.
Breaking Bad.
Yeah, I guess that's true. And the content in Breaking
Everyone
Bad.
Everyone you've watched, Brian, have all been kind of,
But our
Mad Men on there?
Our Wake Up Crew pal, Beth Priest, mentioned Succession here. I don't know. Let's see. Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Yeah, I love that show.
And starring Larry David. Suits from 2011.
I need to watch that.
I finished Suits, nine seasons. It's got Gabriel Macht and Sarah Rafferty and others in that. Really good. It's on Netflix, so you can catch it there. The West Wing from 1999.
You know, I never got into that. I watched it occasionally.
I didn't either.
Some, but I would figure you'd love it because it's political. You know, it's kind of political background.
Yeah, Rob Lowe is in that for a while.
Yeah,
I think.
Matthew Perry's in it. He's good in it when he was on it too. So,
and Martin Sheen is the president.
Yeah,
I think during that time. So,
Not bad. It's pretty good.
I can't remember exactly where you can watch it, but let's
see. Probably Peacock.
It says Max, actually. Okay. Yeah. You can watch that on Max. So there you go. Anything else that you would add to that list?
Mad Men.
Binge-worthy? Yeah, Mad Men is a good one.
Yeah. Very underrated. But if you just want to remember what the 60s looked like, they do a great job of reenacting that. And
from
all
the furniture to the clothes to
cigarettes,
everything.
All that stuff, yeah.
Yeah. Well, that's a look at some binge-worthy shows. Perfect for a lazy weekend. 7:40 now.
Turner Security is proud to offer Honeywell Max Pro Cloud for your business. Control your security, access control, and camera system with one app. Arm your security, see your cameras, and unlock a door for a small monthly fee and no contract. Tired of paying for overnight guard service that doesn't work and costs too much? At Turner Security, we have your solution.
Attention to the individual with a backpack. You are in a restricted area and need to leave immediately.
Video monitoring with real-time live talk from Turner Security.
Turn to Turner Security.
French's Shoes and Boots is the number one place in Tennessee to find the latest Southern styles at unbelievable prices. We know you work hard for your money, so when searching for high-quality footwear that won't let you down, French's has you covered. We have a huge selection of casual and work shoes and boots at the best prices in town, guaranteed.
It makes good sense to shop at French's. French's Shoes and Boots.
1837 South Church Street in Murfreesboro.
Hi, I'm Lee Colvin, your Edward Jones Financial Advisor. And while you've heard the saying, slow and steady wins the race, that same concept can be applied to long-term investing. Investing a little bit at a time on a regular basis can really add up. We call this systematic investing, and though it doesn't guarantee a profit or prevent a loss, it's a way to take advantage of market volatility instead of enduring it. Give me a call, Lee Colvin, at 615-907-7056. Edward Jones, member SIPC.
It's a hard decision to make, knowing when to sell your home and move to Adam's Place.
There's one couple here that I met, and they said it was a lifestyle that they didn't have at home. You have, like, every night dining at a fine hotel. You have the pool. It is so beautiful. Just so much to offer that you won't have in your own home. It's all right here.
Hi, this is Terry Deal at Adam's Place. Call me for more information about Adam's Place. Phone 615-904-9111. Adam's Place.
The Wake Up Crew, WGNS.
With Brian Barrett, John Dinkins, and Dalton Barrett.
7:42 as we put a wrap on this Friday edition of the Wake Up Crew and the week for the two of us here. Episode 1457 in the books, presented and powered by Middle Tennessee Electric. MTE's charitable foundation is called Sharing Change, and it's funded by members like you who round up their electric bills to the nearest dollar each month as a donation and support hundreds of nonprofits. Find out more at sharingchange.org. Today's Good Neighbor of the Day is Brooke Walker. Brooke is today's good neighbor for being there in an eye emergency. Congratulations, Brooke Walker, as our Good Neighbor of the Day today from Ryan Flowers Coffee and Gifts and News Radio WGNS. Now, if you want to send in a good neighbor nomination, just text the word neighbor to 615-893-1450. You'll get a reply from us real quick, and then just fill out the information, click submit. That's all you have to do to get that to us. You can go to our website and submit. If you want to throw it in the mail, we'll take it that way. Even call during the afternoon hours and talk to Melissa. She'll take down the information. We need name, address, phone number, and a sentence why. That's all we need to make your special person the good neighbor of the day.
Time for the dad joke of the day.
Replay.
Well, today's dad joke. You know, the fact that Keith Richards has outlived Richard Simmons really makes me question this whole eating healthy and exercising thing.
Replay.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It's a good excuse, isn't it?
Made it back just in time.
That's dad joke of the day. What have we learned here on the show today?
Well, we learned about the Emmy nominations.
Yep.
A lot of interesting, and we really noticed that very few network shows. Abbott Elementary is about the only one that's represented, which is quite a coup, I guess, for them. But a lot of streaming services have a lot of hit shows. And they're all being nominated as they should be.
Yeah.
And we also talked about binge watching, what you can do on a lazy weekend.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to be lazy this weekend. I'm actually performing.
Performing?
I'm performing on stage at a little small picnic. Well, it's not small, a lot of people, but.
Well, good.
Yeah.
That'll be fun.
The Rigsby's, I have my card if you'd like it.
A little bluegrass music?
Yeah, a little bluegrass, yeah, a little country. More country than bluegrass, I'd say.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that'll be fun. Where's it at?
I don't know the name of the place.
Oh, okay.
I just ride with one of them, and they get me there.
I got you.
And they're gonna comment that I didn't know that, too. They're going to call me.
There were some shows that you said was missing, that were missing from the list.
Yeah. But
of binge-worthy shows.
It's your list, so hey.
It wasn't mine. I found it. But
Lawman wasn't on it.
Well.
5 years of that show, not on it. Cheyenne wasn't on it. Tales of Wells Fargo. For all you people my age, none of those were represented in your binge-watching.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Lawman. Can't beat it. Rifleman. Yeah.
Where do you watch all of those?
You can watch those on the Inspiration Network. Or you can watch it on MeTV or Star Encore Westerns.
Okay. And they're all free, I would imagine.
Yeah. It's me you're talking to. You know why I don't watch the morning show, don't you?
Because you would have to pay for that.
I have to buy a new phone, or that, or buy a new phone, I guess. I wonder if you buy a new phone.
I think it's part of it, or yeah. It can be.
Oh, it's Verizon, though, isn't it? Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe some others. I don't know.
Yeah. iPhone.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, it is Apple.
Yeah.
All right. If you missed part of the Wake Up Crew, check the podcast out. We'll have it up shortly.
Next on the Wake Up Crew, the stupid, silly stat of the day.
Bananas are slightly radioactive due to the potassium, but unless you eat a total of 50 million bananas in your lifetime, you won't reach lethal radiation doses.
Whew, I'm glad. Man, so that makes me feel better.
You're okay.
I can have a lazy binge weekend now.
Yes, with bananas. Getting out of here with our best song, biggest song in 1985.